President Marcos signs an executive order creating the Water Resource Management Office, or WRMO. Marcos says the move will help address the water crisis in the Philippines. Marcos earlier said the first action of the office would be in reducing the country's reliance on groundwater and deep wells.
I am very optimistic that the solutions that we need to formulate are out there. The technologies are out there. What has continued to change in the light of climate change is the management, the stratagems on how we manage our water. We are facing some serious challenges, and we really need to work very, very hard together. Again, I am optimistic because when I look around and I see the technologies and the desire for every, both in the local governments, both in the private sector, the desire to be able to provide this water supply, then that's where my optimism comes from.
The WRMO will be established under the Environment Department. It will serve as a temporary body while the Water Resources Department is being created. Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla calls the oil spill in Oriental Mindoro a big environmental crime. During an interagency meeting this morning, Remulla revealed the oil slick from Oriental Mindoro is still heading towards the Verde Island Passage, known as the center of marine biodiversity in the world.
This defines us as a country on how we really react to situations of this nature and how we resolve problems from our level. Nung nagpunta kami ng Pola, nung isang araw, nakita namin, niliparan namin yung extent ng oil spill. Nagsimula kami sa Verde Island Passage papuntang Pola at nung pabalik sa kabilang side kami dumaan, yung isang helicopter naman, opposite ang dinaanan nila. At nakita namin talaga na papunta na sa Verde Island Passage.
Also in that meeting, the Environment Department said the owner of the sunken tanker that's still leaking oil off Oriental Mindoro may face an administrative fine of up to 471,000 pesos per day. The Philippine Fisheries and Aquatic Resources Bureau urging residents in oil spill hit areas not to consume fish for now. This after the agency found low-level contaminants in fish samples collected in several municipalities in Oriental Mindoro. It detected a class of chemicals which are generally harmful to humans. The agency is also calling on affected local government units to continue imposing fishing bans.
Patuloy po yung monitoring para makita po natin yung progress nitong mga traces na nakita natin sa water samples, pati dito po sa mga laman ng isda, dahil we need to put into context na itong mga initial na result ang nilabas namin, ito po hindi real time. Ikinandak po natin ito ilang araw matapos nga po itong oil spill. Ito pong resulta ng pag-aaral na ginawa po ng DFAR ay hindi pa rin po ito conclusive. Okay. As far as food safety is concerned.
School staff across Los Angeles stage a three-day strike as they continue to demand a pay hike. Steve Angeles reports.
The nation's second-largest school district went on strike. Support staff such as bus drivers, janitors, and cafeteria workers represented by Service Employees International Union 99 have been demanding a 30% pay increase. However, negotiations fell through. The teachers' union, which is also entering negotiations with the school district, joined these staffers in their three-day walkout.
We can't do it without them. They are part of the school. They are part of what we have. They are part of the student success. They are part of what we achieve here at Franklin High School.
Many of the local 99 members, they live under the poverty line. And even with the wages that they're asking for, they would still be under the federal poverty line. And the teachers are standing with these, with the TAs, with the cafeteria workers, because those are the same folks that are the parents of our students. And we are standing with our community.
400,000 students in the Los Angeles Unified School District were out of the classrooms from Tuesday to Thursday. This is the second strike in 4 years at LAUSD, with memories of the 2019 teacher strike still fresh. Ramos, a high school teacher and elected member of the United Teachers Association LA's board of directors, has a second grader himself.
This is the best lesson a student can have in what democracy looks like. I think my son was here in 2019 when he's still a toddler, and he still remembers it and wants to be here with the teachers, with the staff.
It's definitely necessary when people aren't getting paid enough. And the last one was about smaller class sizes, and we made that happen.
LAUSD Superintendent Alberto Carvalho has warned that some of the demands could drive the district towards bankruptcy. He says the district is ready to return to the negotiating table with the SEIU. Rallies continue through the week outside of schools as well as in front of the district headquarters.
With the students locked out of the classrooms until Thursday, the district as well as the city have made some arrangements to give them places to go to during the day as well as a few meals. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.